Home Theatre episode 30 is here, people. And this beautiful room belongs to Sean from Winkinson, United States. Sean's the Chief Operating Officer for an education research company that fell in love with audio ever since he owned a set of Logitech Z560 PC speakers. He's gone through his fair share of different setups throughout the years, until recently he fell in love with DIY equipment that's affordable with a big output, which we'll take a look at in a minute. In 2014, he built his first dedicated home theater room, but didn't quite like a few things about it, such as ceiling height with an awkward bulkhead to one side, the light colored carpet with medium colored paint, which reflected a lot of light, the wall mounted projector that shook because of the subwoofers nearby, and of course, poor acoustic treatment, which a lot of us struggle with. In 2018, his area experienced some flood due to a massive rainstorm and of course destroyed some of his home theater acoustic panels, but luckily managed to save a majority of his equipment just in time. Right before COVID hit in 2019, he moved into a new home which had a 13 by 25 feet basement that had plenty of potential for a dedicated home theater room. With the help of home theater designer tool from audioadvice.com, as well as a riser calculator from AVS forums, he started to sketch and research about his layout and how he can create the ultimate room that's completely soundproofed. After some time, he decided to build a room within a room that included two sets of walls with an air gap in between and a ceiling that dropped below the upper level's floor joists to decouple the home theater from the rest of the house. Double walls and ceiling were filled with insulation and covered it with a vapor barrier. Inside it, all electrical boxes and holes were sealed with putty pads to prevent air leakage in and out of the room, and finished things off with two layers of 5/8-inch fire-rated drywall with green glue in between. Triple flat black wall paint was an easy color choice, which then led him to work on the floor constructing the two risers, first one being 6-inch tall for the front row seating and the back one being 18-inch in height, and finished it off with a plush gray carpet that feels nice on the feet. Since Sean has done so much research before this build, he's made sure sound doesn't exit in and out of the room by creating a double solid core door that kind of acts like an airlock, which made it easy to install thanks to the double wall construction. To get the best seal possible, this door also has an automatic drop down rubber foot at the base when the door is closed, which is pretty cool. And finally, regarding noise control, this would be all a waste if sound could still get in and out of the room from the central HVAC ducts, so Sean's installed a completely isolated HVAC mini split system, which I'm sure by now you guys know from my previous room tours, this is a common setup that works really well. Last but not least, for acoustic treatment, he's chosen to go with GIK acoustics rather than making them DIY panels all over again due to the flood. He's also using bass traps in the front and rear corners of the room, as well as absorption panels along the front wall behind the screen, and some more with scatter plates for the reflection points on the sidewalls. Moving on to the audio in the room, the front LCR speakers that are placed behind the screen, Sean's using the Fusion 15 DIY pack that you can purchase online from DIYsoundgroup.com. They're incredibly dynamic and you'd be surprised how easy they are to drive with a sensitivity of 99 dB. To build these bad boys, it's as simple as a little soldering for the crossover, some gluing and clamping, lining the cabinet with insulation, painting, and voila, you got yourself a very affordable beast. For side surround and rear channels, he's using another DIY pack, the Denovo Vol 10LX, which power ranges between 10 to 450 watts with a retail price of a low $163. These compact high output design wall speakers look fantastic tilted down, and as you guys can see, due to the open wall layout, Sean had to mount one of the side surround speakers between the equipment door and the decor area. Let's talk about bass. Well, I'll let you guys comment on these total of four UXL 18-inch subwoofers that Sean put together. Holy moly. These babies handle up to 1200 watts RMS each, placed in full Marty ported cabinets tuned down to 16 Hz, and regarding of the room size, it delivers low distortion, subtle bass tones for even the most devoted music listener. Yes, that's madness, but put all that aside because it's about to get even crazier. Well, special feature of the risers are that the top 1.5 inch layer is separated and sits on sorber fan isolators. This allows the top platform to vibrate from the force of the subwoofer's driver that's placed directly under the seats, creating a more natural, stronger tactile sensation. Sean got this idea from AVS Forum, which is called a baffle open sub shaker. And in this home theater, we have a total of 8 12 inch JBL subwoofers. That is mind blowing. Let me know if any of you guys have experienced a setup like this before. Let's take a quick detour and check out his AV rack. The equipment closet is off to the side of the room and sealed off to prevent noise from entering the main home theater area. But starting from the top, we have the Oppo BDP-103 3D Blu-ray player. Underneath powering this home theater's amazing equipment is the 9.2 channel Denon AVR4520 receiver. Sean's majorly satisfied with the power output of this beauty, but plans to upgrade to a receiver of similar that's compatible with Dolby Atmos. Next up, to power the Boss platform and his four subwoofers, he's using the Behringer NX3000 that powers the 8 JBL 12-inch drivers and two Behringer NU6000 DSP amplifiers to power two of the 18-inch subwoofers. For those of you that's interested in the AV rack, this is the heavy-duty commercial-grade wire rack on wheels from Amazon, which I'll put the link in the description box to check it out. For display, we have a 125-inch 2.35:1 acoustically transparent DIY screen, which is currently being held up by metal stands on either side, but will be removed to be mounted on the two columns behind the screen. Sean says having his LCR speakers behind the screen is one of the most significant upgrades he's ever done. Of course, now we're going to take a look at the projector, which is sitting inside a heavy-duty black wire shelving rack, which is a very interesting choice, but I think Sean has chosen these to avoid vibration coming from those crazy subwoofers. You can see he's chosen to go with the 4K eShift JVC RS540 projector because of its black levels and 130,000:1 native contrast ratio. And since sci-fi is his favorite genre, he really appreciates what this projector can do with a good out of this world space scenes. As you guys can see, this beautiful theater is very minimal, which is nice. Decor wise, in the back corner, we have some aluminium posters of his favorites, which is built for easy poster replacement, and a nice physical media cabinet for storage. For lighting, Sean's added LED strip lights on the steps of the riser for safety and a couple of up-down wall lights, as well as some down lights around the room to give a bit of that natural modern theater vibe. These comfortable, inviting home theater seats are the FusionScape from Ultimate Home Entertainment, and one feature Sean really loves is the powered headrest, which makes it easier to recline, enjoy the show, and still get a good viewing angle without straining his neck. Sean pretty much ticked most of his upgrade boxes for this room, but plans to add four additional ceiling speakers to enjoy the new Gen 3D immersive movie experience, as well as add two more seats to finish off his re-sitting. Well guys, that's a wrap for Home Theater Room Tour Episode 30. I think considering the room layout, Sean's done an incredible job with how it looks and I'm sure sounds phenomenal. I take my hat off to anyone that builds their own DIY speakers and subwoofers. It takes a lot of patience and precision to create such amazing equipment. Flat packs or not, you got my respect. A build like this shows how affordable a home theater can be with the correct research and some serious determination. Thank you guys so much for watching. Help me out and click on that like button, which will mean a great deal for me and the performance of this video. I'm loving the amount of support you guys give to every owner of these amazing home theater and game rooms. So keep up the positive vibes. And as Sean said, great advice helps all of our experiences. So if any of you guys have any suggestions or questions, you know what to do. I'm out. Peace.